the story of Our Lady of Guadalupe. Juan Diego was an elderly Mexican man born during the Aztec rule. He was a farmer and a laborer who had received no basic education. His faith was very strong, and he never missed the Holy Mass even for a single day. In the early morning dawn of December 9th, Juan Diego was on his way to church to attend the Holy Mass. "It seems like a pleasant morning. I need to walk a bit faster to reach church on time," said Juan Diego. He was hurrying to church when he heard some strange but soothing music. "Huh? What is that music? It is so divine. Where is it coming from? Who is playing it?" he asked himself. "I think it's coming from that hill, the Tepeyac Hill," he went on and checked. Juan was very curious to find out where the music was coming from. So he started to climb the Tepeyac Hill. When he reached the top, he was stunned. He saw Mother Mary. She was surrounded by a radiant light. She appeared as a native princess, and her words sounded more beautiful than the sweetest music ever made. When Mother Mary saw Juan Diego, she spoke to him, gently and calmly. "Juan, it is I, Virgin Mary, Mother of Jesus," she said. "I wish that a shrine be built here in my honor. Here I will give you all my love, my compassion, my help, and my protection. Please, go and tell this to your bishop," the Virgin Mary instructed.
"I will do as you wish, Mother Mary," said Juan Diego.
He then hurried to the bishop's house and told the story to him. However, the bishop did not believe him. He thought that Juan Diego was simply making up the story.
"I am so confused. Maybe I'm just imagining everything. Was it just a dream? I better go back to that hill to check," said Juan Diego.
When he reached the top, he was surprised to find Mother Mary again, as brilliant and as radiant as before.
"Oh, Virgin Mary, the bishop did not believe me. He thinks I'm doing all these for fame,"
said Juan Diego. Mother Mary asked him to return to the bishop again. Juan returned to the bishop and explained to him all that had happened. However, the bishop was still not ready to believe him. He asked Juan Diego to return the next morning with a sign from Our Lady.
"I promise that I will bring back a sign tomorrow morning from Our Lady of Hope," said Juan Diego.
But Juan Diego could not keep his promise. His beloved uncle suddenly fell very ill, and he had to return home to take care of him. He then decided to find a priest for his uncle. When he reached the Tepeyac Hill, he remembered the promise he had made to Our Lady. He did not know how to face Our Lady, so he took a detour and walked around the hill. As he approached the priest's residence, Mary appeared before him. Juan told the Virgin Mary that when he met the bishop had wanted a sign from him, the Virgin Mary, the next morning. He had promised to bring one, but his dear uncle had fallen sick. With great love and kindness, Mary said to him,
"My dear son, let nothing discourage you. Do not fear any illness, anxiety, or pain. Am I not here? I, who am your mother?"
As for the sign for the bishop, Mary told Juan Diego to go to the top of the mountain. "It is winter now. Will there be any flowers growing this cold? But I will do as Mother Mary has told me," Juan Diego replied. When he reached the top, he was surprised to see beautiful flowers blooming there. He plucked the flowers and carefully placed them in his tilma. He then climbed down the hill to show the bishop the sign from Mother Mary. For the third time, Juan Diego went to the bishop's house and the bishop asked for the sign from Mother Mary. The bishop was also waiting to see what sign Juan Diego would bring. He unfolded his tilma and out fell the flowers. There were so many flowers that they covered the floor. Flowers in this cold weather? Surely that is a miracle, said the bishop. Many people had gathered around the bishop's house by now. They were stunned to see Our Lady's image on Juan Diego's tilma. She looked like a native princess. Her head was bowed and her hands were folded in prayer. On her blue cloak, stars seemed to twinkle as they appeared before daybreak, the hour of her first appearance. Juan Diego returned to his house and was surprised to see his uncle well and free from all illnesses. Since then, she was called Our Lady of Guadalupe. The end.